Python type hints might seem like they're just there to label parameter types, return types, or variable types without actually doing anything. But have you ever wondered how FastAPI uses type hints to handle input validation and automatically generate documentation? If you were the developer of FastAPI, how would you make it work? In this video, I'll walk you through the basics of how FastAPI takes advantage of type hints, and at the end, I'll show you a quick code example to tie it all together. To start, let's first figure out how to read type hint information in the first place. When you define a function with all its arguments, that definition is called the function signature. You can access this signature using Python's built-in inspect module. The inspect module has a signature function that does something very straightforward. It takes a callable, like a function, and returns a signature object for it. This signature object contains everything you need to read the type hint information. For example, you can use its parameters attribute to get the function's parameters as a dictionary. The keys of this dictionary are the parameter names, and the values are parameter objects. Each parameter object holds the type hint information you're after, and you can access it through the annotation attribute. This is how FastAPI extracts type hint information. But how does it actually use this to validate input? This is where Pydantic comes into play. Pydantic provides a TypeAdapter class, which lets you create a TypeAdapter object for a given parameter type. Once you have this TypeAdapter object, you can use it to validate values by passing them to its validate Python method. For example, if you pass an integer, it simply returns the same integer. A more interesting case is when you pass a string that can be parsed as an integer. It will validate and return the parsed integer. But if you pass a string that can't be converted into an integer, it throws a validation error. The TypeAdapter is extremely versatile. It doesn't just work with simple types like integers or strings. It also works with more complex types like Pydantic models. For instance, if you pass a dictionary that matches the structure of a Pydantic model, it will return an instance of that model. On the other hand, if the dictionary doesn't match the model's structure, it raises a validation error. Now you know the two key ingredients that power FastAPI's input validation. But there's still one crucial question left. How does FastAPI combine these two to actually perform the validation? Take a moment to understand how this decorator works. You can pause here and read this. It first reads the type hint information for the function's parameters. Then, it creates type adapter objects for each parameter based on their type hints. Whenever the function is called, the decorator validates all the input parameters using these type adapters. If no validation errors occur, it proceeds to call the original function with the validated inputs. This decorator mimics what FastAPI does to perform input validation with type hints. Of course, FastAPI handles much more under the hood, but this example highlights the core idea. If you're curious about the detailed implementation, I've made a separate video walking through the actual code. Feel free to check it out. And if you'd like more content like this on your YouTube feed, don't forget to subscribe.